Howdy, howdy, all y'all. It's time for cake. Well, you know what I always say. I always say, I've been kind of busy. And I have. I figured out a couple things. It took some doing, but I managed to make the Cascading Brewer here work, in spite of how narrow my dang tower was. Now, I had to figure out some things, like this Redcrystal here. This is channeling from this redstone powder here, and it, since it's right up above it, it takes it up, it activates the Redcrystal. That brings it over to here, because Redcrystal can go around corners in addition to being stuck to walls. And of course that activates the adjacent Redcrystal. So what we're looking at here is a band of Redcrystal that goes all the dang way around. And in addition to that, oh, I need my wand. Can't do things without the wand. Alright, well, there we go. Let's see now. There we are. Okay, so where was I? Right. Where? Oh, come on. There we go. So our hourglass here, y'all can see the timer set to 20 seconds. Signal pulse, it's on repeat. If you touch it, it moves the sand to the bottom, if it's already running. And it would flip the hourglass if it got a signal in the side, but it's not going to get one because it's the only thing given a redstone signal. Now, after going to all this trouble to set this here thing up, I have to say a couple words about how well it works. These cobble blocks are here because there's a whole lot of aura up there already. Y'all can see that these capacitors are just pumping it back and forth between each other. There's lots just ready to come down, so when I break these blocks, that's going to happen. But overall, these projectile aura pumps, and the way I set this up is I've got my dispenser underneath it, and I got arrows in there. These projectile aura pumps, you know, they're not bad, but you go through an awful lot of arrows. And I could not help but notice that among the other changes in this most recent episode, DrasticDemise appears to have bumped up the cost of arrows. So that ain't going to be so easy anymore. But for the time being, it was worth trying. Now, I'm also going to say our Cascading Brewer here, it ain't so much fun either. We're going to drop a water bottle in. No, we're not. Come here, give me that. We're going to drop a water bottle in. Did that land in there, or did I throw it over? I threw it over. Dang, I'm good. We're going to drop a water bottle in. Good enough. When I break that cobble, it'll fall. I can deal with that. And the problem is that it takes running it forever to make it work, because first it's going to take our water bottle. We can see it by looking at it with the thermometer. It's a water bottle. Oh, come on. Bah. There, dang it. I think that went in. No. Alright, I'm going to break it after I put the cobble away. Anyhow, you throw the water bottle in, the first thing it does is it turns it into an awkward potion. And that takes a while. And then it goes and turns it into whatever other kind of potion. You got no control over it. You burn a lot of energy just getting it to the awkward potion stage, and then a lot more energy just getting it to the next stage. So here we go. Our mana should start coming down. We drop a water bottle out there. There we go. Well, a little bit came down. Okay. And that should have turned the thingy into a, there we go, an awkward potion. But now look how long it takes it to get up again to the next level here. I may have to kick up some more aura. I don't know if it'll make 25 on what was up there. Yeah, maybe it will. Yep. Okay, what do we get? We got a potion of strength. Hooray. Now, the problem here is that if we started out with the progress at zero and just let this puppy run, you know, we would have gone through probably about, I don't know, a dozen arrows to get that. So it's kind of not as useful as y'all might think. Wow. Okay, that was a lot of aura stored up there. Anyhow, yeah. That's not so useful as you might think. I've got into the habit of blocking the downdrafts, as it were, and then pumping a lot of aura up, and then just letting it fall. Some folks have pointed out that I misunderstood how aura works. If you got, say, these puppies, usually, the way these things work, is they pump 1,000 power per second for 20 seconds every time you hit them with an aura, or with an arrow. That means if they're lifting it by 10, that's divided. So if it is lifting it up 10 blocks, each of these projectile pumps is only lifting 100 power per second. Well, that's 15 blocks. Or no, that's 10 blocks. That's 10 blocks. So each of these is only lifting 100 power per second. So that means each time it fires off a set of arrows here, each one of these puppies lifts 2,000 power. So four arrows is getting me 8,000 power. Now you compare that to one block of TNT, which lifts 100,000 of red aura, and you begin to see why I'm not so super enthused, I suppose, about this particular system. But hey, I learned a lot building it. I got myself to work with Redcrystal some more. I don't think I scanned that stuff. Nope, there we go. Have I scanned these? Can I scan them? Yeah, okay. I don't think I scanned my hourglass either. Well, that was nice. But, yeah, it's dispensers, seriously? Yeah, can't learn anything from the brewer. Anyhow, it was a learning experience, and, you know, I'm all right with that. Now, the other thing you can see I did from here is that I moved all of the carpeting off the top of the big old drum over there, and I have shifted all of my mana, or not mana, all of my Botania stuff over there, and the only thing that's really left back at the old homestead, well, let's head over there for a quick second. All that's left over here is our buddy the golem. Uh-oh. Where is my buddy the golem? Something killed my golem. Okay, well, so much for that. Anyway, the tree farm, which I'm going to have to take down, I can see. And a couple of these here mob inhibitor blocks. My passive mobs, because I ain't too sure how to move them. And I can just make more with the fairy ring. And here's a chest full of loose ends. And here's my nether wart farm and my sugar cane. And my cactus. Oops. Busted one. That's all that's left here. Nothing else. I have moved out all my Botania stuff. I shut down my hydrangeas this turn here. For those of you who are not aware, the latest changes that have been made to Botania have made it so that hydrangeas and day blooms and nightshades all die after 3 Minecraft days. They're just temporary. They're just there to get you to bootstrap your way up. So Vasky apparently was not 100% pleased with the whole Tower of Flower Power tactic, and as a result, we no longer have our Towers of Flower Power. Take that with me. But yeah, I mean, this is, I'm getting ready just to turn out the lights here, I tell you. Okay. So I'll come back here and I'll get rid of all this other stuff. I mean, there's a fair bit of wood and saplings in there, that's for sure. Anything in the furnace? Nope. So that's all there really is to it. I mean, not a lot here. Not no more. Okay, so getting back to where all the action is. Let's see now. I'm still loving the heck out of this thing. It's so awesome. I got my own plasma ball here. Okay, so I have moved all my mana pools, and in order to do that, I made a couple mana tablets. 2 mana tablets, you dump them into a mana pool, and they will pretty much suck it dry if you turn the mana pool onto distribute mana instead of take mana in. See, right now it's putting out, and now it's putting in. You can see the lightning coming up, and for once the lightning isn't gray, and you can see it's just sucking it right out of there. And it'll fill both the tablets, it'll empty the pool. So I want to do 2 things today if I can. The first is I really want to try to make some Terrasteel, because I ain't never actually accomplished that. And the second is I want to make a portal to Alfheim, which is something else I ain't never actually accomplished, partly because you need Terrasteel. Oh, we got a master Cavenic skeleton out here someplace. He's over there somewhere. They're neat if they show up. You know, you kill them and it's instant easy Cavenium. Somebody just shot at me. Where are you? Show yourself. Alright, I don't see it. You see it? I don't see it. Ain't nothing there. That's weird. Are you kidding me? There you are. Oh, son of a gun, I bet that's him. Yep, look at that. There goes his health bar. This is hilarious. And apparently I'm just outside his perception range here. This is terrible. This is kind of cheesy. But, you know, I'm not going to turn down free Cavenium. And why get myself shot up? And there we go. He is dead. So now I should be able to come over here. If I remember my stairway right here, this should take me up. Oops. I can jump. Anyhow, so yeah, portal to Alfheim. That's on the schedule. That's what I want to do today. Just as soon as I pick up my winnings, as it were. Well, it's got to be well above this, because I ain't even at an altitude yet where I can see the roof. Okay, there's the roof. Here, loot, loot, loot. Was he over here? I ain't too sure. No, he was higher up than this. Let's try that. Wow, I don't think he was quite that high. Okay. Let's try going down a little. Maybe. Oh, there's a pretty looking node right there. Ah, an experience orb. That's a good sign. Maybe. And more experience orbs. Okay, but where is the loot? Ah, there it all is. Pardon me, sir. There we go. Yeah, look at all that cavenium. Oh, he dropped a cavenic bow, too. I've already got one, but hey, that's neat. Did I already read you? Yeah, all right. Okay, so, pardon me, I'm easily distractible. Let's teleport back. And let's get things underway. I have no idea why that's there. Anyhow, so, first thing we're going to need to do is we're going to need to make an agglomeration plate. And after we make the agglomeration plate, we're going to need to make a checkerboard of lapis blocks and living rock. So we're going to need 4 lapis blocks for that. We're going to need 3 lapis blocks for this, a block of mana steel, fire ruin, air ruin, mana ruin, earth ruin, and water ruin. So, let's get out the lapis. Yeah, I think I may have that much. Let me see, 7 total, I think. Let me just check here. 3 for that. 4 for that. Yep, 7. Man, the neighbors are noisy again. Okay. So let's see. Whoop, missed. Whoa! I swear, everybody's a critic. Some days. I'm gonna have to make some kind of a little parapet here. So stuff is not constantly attacking me. Let's see, I don't need that. Okay, Mr. Creeper, now you're making me a little irritable. There we go. All right. Take care of that. And we'll throw that over the side. Take care of that. Let's dispose of some of this stuff in my inventory that I don't need here just this second. We got 18 refined and 1 normal. Dang, that was sweet. Alright, so, moving right along. Envy, no. But we do need fire. And we need water. And we need air. And we need earth. What is that, sloth? And we need mana. I only have 1 mana. Okay, I'm going to have to work on making more of them. And I'm going to need a block of mana steel. Wow. That's quite a lot. Let's see here. Let's put you away for now. So that goes in the middle. 3 of those. I remember that The mana rune was in the center. Let's look and see where the other ones are. Fire, air, earth, water. Okay. Fire, air, earth, and water. That's a lot of runes. There we go. There is our terrestrial agglomeration plate. Now this is kind of turning into my workspace here. I don't want to encroach too close to my pure daisies. But let's look at putting that puppy right about here. Now I'm going to need, I think, 5 of these. Yep, 4 lapis, 5 of these. So, boop. And the plate. And whoop, there it went, I think. Maybe. All right. So the way this thing works, this is very, very expensive. The way this puppy works, we drop a single mana steel ingot, a single mana diamond, and a single mana pearl on top of that. Now for the next thing I want to do, and we have to have a mana spreader aimed at this puppy. Because this takes about, half a mana pool, it says. Well, let's see if I can hit this thing without. Okay, that looks good. But that mana pool's empty. All right, well. There we go. And that should only take a moment to refill. Now, while that is happening, I want to have a quick look at the portal to Alfheim. And the first part of that is we're going to need 8 living wood blocks, 3 glimmering living wood blocks. And then we're going to need an Elven Gateway Core, 2 Natura Pylons, and 2 Mana Pools. Now, the Elven Gateway Core and the Natura Pylons take Terrasteel Nuggets. And that is part of why I want to make some Terrasteel today. These all done? They're all done. Okay, so 1 Mana Diamond, 1 Mana Pearl, and already got mana steel ingots, so let's do this thing. And a 1, and a 2, and a 3. Yeah, that's happening. I like that. Sweet. Taking a little while. Of course, it is supposed to drain half the pool. If that's going to drain half the pool, that's going to take like a minute or so. Well then, let's see, there was 3 glimmering living wood. Okay, that's going to take living wood blocks. And we are going to need us glowstone. How's that pool doing? It doesn't seem to be moving a whole heap. Even though the mana spreader's doing its thing. Okay, I'm gonna duck downstairs. Because it doesn't look like it's gonna finish immediately. Now, I have most of my stuff sorted, but what I don't have is I'm trying to remember where I put my glowstone. Because I need glowstone to make glimmering living wood. There it is. And to do that, we take our living wood, we take some glowstone, and there we go. We have our glimmering living wood. That is the only part of this recipe that's easy. Everything else, gonna take the doggone mana steel blocks. Or Terrasteel blocks. How's that coming? Man, it hasn't budged much. Well, the three blue thingamies have moved closer to the middle. So I guess it's getting its thing on somehow. I am going to go ahead and I'm going to dump these two here. Oops, didn't mean to do that. There we go. And let's empty you out. I'm going to need to move two of the mana pools to set up the altar, so I may as well start one of them draining now. Man, how it's taking its own sweet time, I must say. That sure don't look like it's going to take half a mana pool to do it. I hadn't realized how long that was going to take. Okay, let's do that. And let me get some more living wood. Now, I've mentioned before about how marvelous Botania's setup is, but I want to show you this thing. Look at this. Gives us a system for laying it out. That's pretty sweet. So I'm going to go ahead and break this mana pool. And I'm going to put this a puppy right over here. And put another one over here. How's that doing? Man. So slow. So slow. It's moving. It's just not moving very fast. Okay. So I'm going to take these things. Oops. There. Wow. So slow. Well, they're filling up that mana pool. It's got some kind of a little glowing rune thing going on in there. I don't know. While that's happening. Oh, shoot. Did I just... Oh, they're done. Okay. Whoops. Hello? Hello? Where's my Terrasteel? What happened? Is it in here? It ain't in my inventory. That stuff's bright green. It ain't down here neither. What just happened to my Terrasteel? I don't like this. I don't like this a bit. That was weird. Okay. I'm gonna try one more time, fellas. I don't know what that was about. I mean, it was set up right. I didn't grab the stuff off it by accident. It's not in my inventory. I don't know what happened. Let's try again. Oh, I need to turn the mana diamond into a regular, or the diamond into a regular, or into a mana diamond. Okay. Huh. I wonder what it did. I'm gonna move this. Just in case somehow that interfered with things. I don't get that at all. I don't get how that could have happened. There. So we'll start draining that mana pool. I'm going to come over here, put that there, and a living wood block, and block glimmering living wood, and another living wood block. Now I'm all nervous about it and stuff. So strange. Okay. And that ain't gonna make matters easier. Let's see. I mean, it looks like it's doing its thing, but it looked like it was doing its thing last time. I am not reassured. Okay. All we're missing is this piece, and we need Terrasteel to make that piece. And the two pylons. I need Terrasteel to make the two pylons. So all I can do at this point is put the other mana pool over here. Oh, it's already here, ain't it? Yeah, okay. And they're loading it on up. Okay. If this don't work, I'm not real sure what I'm gonna do. We're 33 minutes in, but more important, I mean, if I can't make Terrasteel, then, I mean, you know, I can't do an awful lot of Botania stuff, particularly the high-end stuff. I can't do nothing, because it all depends on Terrasteel. Now, I know it said if you take the stuff out of there that that it disrupts the process, but let's unvisualize. There. Yeah, we know what goes where. I know it said if you take the stuff out of there that it'll disrupt the process, but I don't think I went close enough to do that, and even if I had, why would it make everything go away? Picking up and causing severe mana loss. I didn't lose a ton of mana. I mean, I got my pool here is still very, very full looking. And even if it did lose a lot of mana, I mean, I'd still get my stuff back, you know, if it didn't make the bar. I don't know what's up with this, fellas. I just don't. But it's making me plenty nervous, I tell you that. Little bit afraid to take my eyes off it now. I mean, all I got left to do is to get the Terrasteel, use it to make the gateway log, and then use it to make the mana pylons. Well, I could work on making, because the mana pylons require regular pylons. Yeah, that's That looks pretty straightforward to me. What? What? What happened? I don't understand what happened. Where's everything else? Why did it give me Mana Steel? Something's wrong here. Something's very wrong here. That makes me irritable. Because I cannot continue. Does it stack? Yeah, that's real Mana Steel. Why are you bugging out on me? Okay, that's the right thing under it. I mean, I think it wouldn't make the multi-block if I had the wrong thing under it. I do not know what the heck the problem here is. Yeah, okay. There's living rock under the plate. Yeah, did that. It doesn't do nothing fancy to tell me, hi, I'm working. And it didn't lose a ton of mana. I mean, I lost less than an eighth of the pool there. But I can't finish what I was doing without Terrasteel. And it took my items and it didn't give me the Terrasteel. So I'm bothered, fellas. I'm gonna have to bug report this or something. I don't know. But we're 38 minutes in, so I'll have to do it some other day. Y'all have a good one. Thanks for stopping in. Tell all your friends. Cake's good for you. All right, folks. I did a little bit of poking around, and it seems that what happens is that using a mana spreader ain't fast enough. And some of the items despawn, and then everything goes to hell. So my guess is the first time around, I pitched out all the items close enough together, they all despawned at once. The second time, I must have kicked out that Mana Steel ingot a little late, and I saw the other items despawn, and I was able to pick it up. But what this all comes down to is, in order to make this thing work, we gotta use the right equipment. So the right equipment in this case is a thing called a spark. And sparks, let me see here, where is my other, there they are. Sparks are mana manipulation, and they use blaze powder, gold nuggets, a couple yellow mana petals or other color mana petals. Now I'm pretty sure I got some blaze powder floating around. It's probably downstairs. That's not something I've been using a lot of, so you'd figure, well, hopefully you'd figure it's in here someplace. Alternatively, I'm thinking, because the nether zones are so rare, and I haven't spent much time, there's some blaze powder. Man, I was about to talk myself into believing I didn't have any. Okay, so that ought to make us a couple sparks. And I'm going to need some gold nuggets. There's two of them. And then I'm going to need myself a couple petals. So let's grab that. What have I got a ton of? 33, 32, 34, 35, 38. Yeah, I think we can spare some of that. Okie doke. So let's see now. Gold nuggets in the middle. Petals top and bottom. Oh, I'm going to need more, aren't I? Okay, well. There we go. And blaze powder on the sides. And that should... Why isn't that working? Okay, hang on. What did I do wrong? Blaze powder. Petal. Mana petal. That's the problem. That is the problem. There we go. And there we go. Okay, so let me get this the heck out of the way. Now we're going to take one of these, put it here. Party. Is there a quest for making these things? Let's see here. Sparks fly. Spark 101. Rewards 100%. Why isn't it? That's weird. That's very weird. Alright, I'm having troubles today. I don't know what the trouble is, but what the heck. So we'll put one there, and we'll put one there. And now I've got a mana steel ingot and a mana pearl. I'm going to have to make another mana diamond. I've got two sparks there. Oh, you know, I bet what it is, I already completed that. Yep, that's what it is. Silly me. I need to keep better track of these here things. Okay, let's get a diamond. And we're going to hook that in here. Now it's a mana diamond. Now, hopefully, this time it's all going to work. And it should be a lot faster now. Whoa, look at all that stuff go. Yeah, and look how fast the pool's draining. You can see it going down. Okay, so we never got near that far last time. Okay. Yeah, that's what I wanted. One Terrasteel ingot. Man, that was a lot of work. Okay, well, let's crack this puppy up because we're going to need bits. Now, where's our recipe book? There we go. Alphamancy. What we need is the gateway core. That's a half dozen living wood. And three of these things. There we go. We'll just plug that sucker in where it belongs. Okay. And the other thing we're gonna need is we're gonna need mana pylons. Hello, again. Oh, you're Mr. Rapid Fire, are you? Where'd you even go? That was weird. Did he fall down? Screw it. Busy. Working. Okay. So that's going to use up the last six of our Terrasteel nuggets. And we're going to need a couple eyes of ender. And I'm going to need another mana pylon. So that's two more mana diamonds. Some more mana steel ingots. How am I doing on mana steel ingots? I got none. I need to make at least three. So I'm going to need four gold, three iron ingots, two diamonds. Okay, and there's our two diamonds. And I'm just gonna temporary kind of like shove stuff in here. I'll take it out later. Four gold, two diamonds, and three iron. Okay. And we'll toss our iron in here. And we'll toss our diamonds in there. Tossing the gold in, we don't need to do. Alright, I believe gold was top and bottom. And yeah, there's our mana pylons. So we'll need one of them in the middle. And we need nuggets out along three of the four sides. And then the final thing we need is an eye of ender. So for that, I'm going to have to get a couple more blaze powder. Man, I don't have tons left. I got 13 rods. Okay. There's my ender eyes. And there's my nature pylons. So I'm going to put them down. Okay. Do I need to click it or something? Let's see here. Okay. Yeah. Open up the portal, right click the core with a wand of the forest. Alright. Now, from what I saw, it takes about a quarter of the pools to open it up. And then it'll start to slow down. Yeah, nice. Purdy. I like that. I like that a lot. That's quite awesome. Okay, yeah, that ain't taking that. It's not draining it real quick. Not seeing it move at all, really. Nope. Okay, that one moved a bit. Nope, that's about it. So it ain't even a quarter. Maybe between the two of them it took a little more than an eighth. But, we'll keep an eye on it. I'll see what happens. Now, the thing here is, this lets us get new recipes. And to do that, we got to take our book, toss it in, and then they toss it back. Contains two schools of knowledge, Minecraftian knowledge and Elven knowledge. Elven GARDE. Yeah. Okay. Greetings, we noticed our portal was open via link from another one. Okay. Nice, 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 nice. Okay. Yeah. All right. The only problem I see here is that clearly stuff coming out of it is going to come out behind it. So, I'm going to need to make a little more space on the far side of this. How are these doing? Well, they haven't shifted much, have they? Okay. So, I'm going to go downstairs. And I'm going to get myself a little more holy stone. And I'm going to build a little platform behind that thing. Missed it. Okay. There we go. That ought to be plenty. All right. So now relics of the Aesir. Portal to Alfheim, resources of Alfheim. Dreamwood, Elementium, Pixie Dust, or Dragonstone. Okay, so Living Wood turns to Dreamwood. Dreamwood Twigs. Oh man, 2-1 to make Elementium. Ow. Okay. And one mana pearl makes some pixie dust. And mana diamond, it's 1-for-1 with Dragonstone. Okay. Well, I know one of the things I'm going to be using next time around is I know I want some pixie dust. So I'm going to take two of these. I'm going to come over here. There we go. And there we go. That's how the portal works. Awesome. How are we doing here? It's not like burning heaps of mana. I'll be able to keep it going. Worst comes to worst, I can take some of the mana out of these two pools, use the tablets, bring it over here. But the next thing I want to do, and the thing I want that pixie dust for, is next episode we're going to work on a higher caliber Botania mana generation system. So, having straightened all that craziness out, figured out what the heck I was doing wrong, and so on and so forth, I'm going to go ahead and wish you all goodbye. Have a wonderful day. Thank you for watching, and tell your mom, cake is good for you.